my office is a mess right now. I've got boxes of electronic stuff all, everything's pulled out of the closet. And the reason that it's pulled out of the closet is right here. So here's the new Dell Optiplex I bought. Well, it's not exactly new. It's new to me, though. And I've got this little breadboard here wired up. What I've done is I've got a USB connector and I've got a parallel port connector right here. And they're running over to this little board here. Yeah, it looks like something out of Frankenstein, I know. But let me show you what I've got. These are all of the pinouts from the CNC software. And here I've got 5 volts and ground that I stole from a USB port. And then here is a little circuit board I put together. It's got some switch inputs, and I've got a couple of the outputs going over here to see if they work. So anyway, if we go over here to this, and I launch the program, enable the program, and I go over here to the motor controller, you see how I can turn the motor on, turn the motor off, motor on and motor off. One of the things I did notice was that when the computer was not running the program, that pin was turned on. So what I think I'm going to have to do is take one of the pins and make like an enable or something out of it so that the motor doesn't inadvertently start up. But that's all part of the fun of getting this thing going. I'm going to disconnect it, take it outside, and start hooking it up to the mill. And maybe we'll get some movement today. That'd be awesome. If not, I got to go to work for a week out of the state, so it'll have to sit there until I get back. I wanted to give you guys a little bit of an idea of what's going on out here in the shop. Eve's side of the shop, the woodworking side, is looking pretty good. Her machine's kind of clean and everything. The shop's a bit of a mess. I've been working on the mill some more. I got this one all put together now. That's the x-axis, and I kind of want to give you an idea of what I'm doing. And I used to use these, which are just a piece of Delrin to connect the two points, but they're kind of rigid, and so I was getting some creaking, and it wasn't too good on the encoder. That's the digital encoder. So what I did was I put in these misalignments. I was going to originally put one in, and I had to make a piece to fit here anyway, and I decided they weren't that expensive, so I put two in, and then I made a coupling shaft. This is the digital encoder that I'm using. That's a 500 line encoder, and so I really get a lot of accuracy out of the machine this way. As you can see, I still got all my cables. I've got to thread all them down in there, and they come around over here to the Gecko drive, which is located up inside of here. I got to get that wired up. Once that's wired up, it'll be good to go. This mill's never had limit stops before, so I'm putting in some Hall effect sensors, and I've got a magnet in there. This is the Z-axis, and then somewhere around in here, I've got to figure up some kind of enclosure to mount the magnet, and then I have to do the same thing over here on the X-axis. And then once I get that done, it'll be nice because I'll be able to hit zero on the machine and have it get to the same point every time. So still got a lot of work to do on it, but it's coming along. Now we're going to see if all of the adjustments paid off. I've got this set 1 inch from the end. This is a 2-inch dial gauge. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to come over here and I'm going to tell it to go G01, which means move at a given feed rate, to the zero position at a feed rate of 2 inches per minute. I'm going to tell it go, and you can see that it's now moving. So this thing will complete 10 sweeps, and when it's done, that sweep hand should be on zero, and we'll see how accurate this machine is. It's got about 2/10 of an inch to go, about 1/10 of an inch to go. Boom. And it looks like it's about 0.5 off, 1/1000 of an inch off maybe. So it's not bad, not bad. Especially because the setup's got a little play in it. So I'm thinking the machine's set pretty well right now. Now what I'm doing is I'm working on the Z-axis. Got to get all these wires connected up in here, get a capacitor put in there. And then up here, see, that's the top housing for the Z-axis. That's that piece of plastic I told you I'm going to replace with two of those misalignment couplers and a piece. But for right now, I'll be able to put it together and test it out. Technically, I'll be able to mill something. And then once I've got it running and I can mill something, I'll make the brackets for the limit switches and then go through the calibration and should be back online. So, but right now, I'm tired. It's time to take a break. I've been at this thing since about 10 o'clock this morning and I'm done. Good machine, but I'm just tired. I'm done.